PT&T, we want you back.
Excuse me?
If you switch from PT&T to PT&T 2, we want you back. And now, thanks to our Comrades Call Comrades program, we can save you up to 6 rubles a year on long distance to the motherland.
PT&T? What is this? Look, I just want to make a phone call.
Identify. This is operator 934. Identify. This is operator 934. You will state your telephone permit number now. You are in violation of section 33956 of the California Penal Code. Your location has been traced. Please remain with this unit until a communications security team arrives.
Thanks. I'll try again later.
So will result in...
You're listening to PLA Radio, episode number 27, recorded on February 26th, 2010. I'm Redbox Chili Pepper. This episode is going to explore the internet's latest social media craze known as Foursquare, where people all over the world are knowingly transmitting their locations to complete strangers with updates like this.
I'm at the Starbucks at 1460 Broadway in New York getting a white chocolate mocha and blueberry muffin, LOL!
And where PLA fans all over the world are calling up these attention-starved people and freaking them out with calls like this.
Sage and Zulark, this is JC.
Hello, I was wondering if it'd be possible to talk to a person that's in there right now. Her name's Carly Irwin.
Carly Irwin. Mm-hmm. All right, let me see if I can find her.
Okay, thanks.
Hello?
Hey, Carly.
Who is it?
It's Roy. Happy birthday.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, sure. Hey, listen, I'm from the internet, and I'm a stalker, and I've decided to start stalking you, like, via Foursquare.
That's great.
So I'm just going to call you everywhere you go and have you paged and say crazy things to you.
That sounds great. Wait, who is this, really?
Oh, my name is Roy. I'm from the internet. I live in Oregon.
Okay.
So I'm just gonna stalk you forever now, okay?
All right, sounds good, Roy.
But happy birthday anyway.
Are you serious? You're really Roy from Oregon? You're not one of my friends telling a joke?
No, I'm not your friend at all. No offense or anything.
Okay.
Okay, well, I'll see you at the next place you go.
I think I might stop using force.
Oh, no, don't do that. That's no fun. That ruins it for me.
All right, well, you have a good night, Roy.
All right, bye. Jerk.
Bye.
I'm going to be lazy with this episode and just insert a portion of this week's phone show where me, Linear, and Ninex talk about the insanity of Foursquare. Here it is.
They should have, you know, thought about that before, you know, the shit hit the fan and everybody, you know, started flipping out about it.
Yeah, it's getting a lot of media attention this week. It's pleaserobme.com. And are you aware that, like, the PLA forums have been using it to terrorize people?
No, I'm not. That's actually very hilarious.
Yeah, that's why we were going to talk about it. And we're going to play a prank call. So, you know, they use Foursquare, and Foursquare is a service that works alongside Twitter and Facebook, and it's for attention whores who want people to know, like, every little place they go. Like, you know, I'm at the coffee shop now, I'm at the gym now, I'm at Walgreens now, buying medicine. And every day, like, these people use Foursquare and they just check in every place they go. And
yeah, you know, why would you want people to know? I personally like to have my privacy. I don't want people fucking knowing everything I do, you know?
Yeah, and that's sane and rational. But I guess the thinking behind it, which is you're not supposed to use it like these people use it. You're supposed to be like, hey, we're all at the bar now. Come on out.
Yeah, well, or it would be cool, like, if you go to a bar and you say, I'm at this bar, And then you see all the other people that are at the bar, and you say, hey, people, I'm on Foursquare too, and meet people, I guess.
And like, yeah, I mean, which makes some sense, but yeah, I think privacy is probably more important. But that's not really how it's being used. It's just being used to tell mundane and insignificant
and
shit.
The thing I've noticed, besides the people that use Foursquare all have like blogs with domain names and everything, because they're so starved for attention, I think. But
I completely agree.
People are putting their home addresses and home coordinates on there, and they're checking in when they go home. And they're putting their work coordinates and addresses and names and stuff on them and checking into work. Like, they just check in nonstop all day until we call them.
I know. And you know, it's just like, okay, fine. Like you guys said, maybe if everybody wants to meet up at a bar or something like that, that's fine. But then you get these people that, like you said, constantly update their locations all the time. I don't care if you're driving down the interstate. I don't care if you're at work. I don't really give a shit.
I'm checking into exit 5.
Exactly. Hey, you know what? I don't fucking care.
Thank you for calling Walgreens, located at southwest corner of Smith and McGowan.
Thank you for calling Walgreens. This is how may I help you?
Hello, could I have somebody paged there? His name is Gil.
Do you want me to page him for cosmetics?
Oh, I just want to know if I could maybe talk to him on the phone. It's important. He doesn't have a cell phone on him.
Okay, let me see.
His name's Gil Velasquez.
Hold on.
That's a weird shit. Yeah.
Hey, is this Gil? Gil, it's Gil from the future. It's you. I'm you. Listen, I know it's hard to believe, but don't buy any Tylenol tonight. It's very important. Okay? It's of utmost importance.
Okay.
Yeah, just no Tylenol. Any other brand, but no Tylenol.
Listen, I don't know who the fuck this is, but I'm about to have it with your bullshit.
Your future depends on it.
Yeah, okay, whatever.
I'm from the year 2016.
Go fuck yourself.
I'm serious. Oh, hello. Can I talk to a customer that's in there right now?
I think you got a wrong number. This is West New Salon.
Yeah, I know that. She's a customer in there. Her name's Nicole Stefanet.
Oh, you want to talk to Nicole? Hold on, okay?
Okay.
Just a second.
Hello?
Hey, Nicole. This is Chris Tompkinson. I'm at the corporate office here at Foursquare, and we wanted to tell you it's a bad idea to publish where you're at because, you know, then stalkers call you and stuff. And you don't want stalkers calling you because that's crazy. So we're going to have to ask that you cut that out or we're going to cancel your account.
Isn't that the point of it?
Well, yeah, but then stalkers are going to call you wherever you go. And that's creepy. It's creepy.
Oh, my gosh. Well, hey, I really like it, though. But now you're just creeping me out.
You don't want people stalking you. It's no fun. I've been there.
Then why use the application in the first place?
I don't know. You know, like, I don't know. You can figure out something else to do with it. Just don't tell people where you're at, though.
Okay, thanks for the warning.
Are you having your nails done right now?
Yes, I am.
Really? Am I messing it up by making you pick up a
no.
phone?
No. Nope. It's toes only.
Oh, I see. That's good. Okay.
Yes.
Well, I hope they look really cute.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Don't be so dumb with the posting your location info.
Okay.
From now
you.
On.
Okay.
Use more caution.
I will.
All right. Bye.
Okay. Bye.
Oh, hello. Would it be possible to page a customer that's there?
Yeah. Who did you try to reach?
His name is Shaggy Jenkins.
We'll go by the name Shaggy. And... Okay. Hold on.
Thanks.
Hello.
Hello, this is Paul from the Red Cross, and we're calling asking for donations tonight.
Okay.
And I'd like to know if you'd like to donate this year like you did last year.
How in the heck did you do this?
What are you talking about?
How did you know I'm in a restaurant?
Well, we're with the Red Cross. We're trying a new thing. It's a proactive telemarketing.
Because
it's hard to reach people at home these days, so... I was just wondering if we could count on your support this year.
Sure, why not?
Okay, would you like to donate $25 then to help the people in Haiti?
Could you tell me who you are?
This is Roy with the Red Cross.
I thought you were Paul.
Paul Roy. I don't see what's so funny, because, you know, that's an unfortunate name, and I've had to be made fun of my entire life, and I don't appreciate it. Could we count on your donation, your support?
not. I'm sorry. I'm going to call and just... Who is this?
My name's Paul.
Paul Roy.
Yeah, from the Red Cross.
Red Cross.
I'm just telemarketing.
This is telemarketing. You called the restaurant line for telemarketing?
That's right. I mean, it's tough times for people in Haiti, and they need help, and we need to count on people
but
like
I
you to support them.
I have a cell phone.
We're not allowed to call cell phones. It's against FTC regulations.
No, hang on.
Are you not interested in donating this year, then? We can't count on your support?
Nothing much, man.
Well, I'm sorry?
I did.
What?
Hold on, I've got to call on the other line. All right.
If it's UNICEF, you tell those motherfuckers.
Yeah, but you know, and like you said, it's these people that are starved for attention and I guess feel like they, you know, should have this privilege of, you know, being quote-unquote famous or whatever.
But anyway, what we're getting at here is, okay, what the PLA forums have been doing is we've been, well, mostly just me and Grishnav, but we've been, you know, people check in, we use pleaserobme.com, and, you know, it shows you up to the minute, up to the second when people are checking in. And
but it also shows you the business address and location of where they're checking in.
Yeah, you click on one link and it shows you the business name and phone number. You click on the other link and it shows you the person's name who just made the tweet. So we call up the business and we say, hey, is so-and-so there? Put them on the phone. It's really important. And then we say crazy things to them.
Thank you for calling Trace for Walgreens.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hi. Hey, listen, I'm so sorry to bother you with this. My friend Kelvin said he was going there a few minutes ago, and mm-hmm. something really important came up, and I need to talk to him, but he's not answering his cell phone. I think maybe he left in his car or something. Is there any way you could, like, page him and, like, bring him to a phone or something?
What is his last name?
Chico, C-H-I-C-O. His first name's...
Chico? Calvin?
Kelvin. K-E-L-V-I-N.
Okay,
thank you so much.
All right.
Hello?
Hey, is this Kelvin?
Yes.
Kelvin, do not buy the Tylenol. I'm you from the future. Okay? And listen, the Tylenol, it just screws everything up for us. All right? You understand?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
You can get acetaminophen, but do not buy the Tylenol.
I have no idea what you're talking about. Who's this?
This is you from the future. Like, we were at, earlier that day, if I remember right, like Panera Bread, right? This is you. It's the year
20... I recognize my voice, bro.
No, see, look, the Canadians invaded and took over, so we all had to change our accents, all right? That's the deal.
Yeah.
In 2015, you got to be ready for that too. But we do okay, all right. But look, we can't get the Tylenol because it totally screws everything up. You understand? Like it's a tainted.
No,
batch.
I don't understand because
it's a tainted.
What you doing? Following me on freaking Foursquares and shit.
We can get any other brand, but the Tylenol we get is tainted. And it takes our vision away, and I'm blind.
Uh huh.
Yeah. So that's the deal. All right.
How long is my hair?
It's about 18 inches, I think, back then.
Yeah.
Maybe a little. Yeah, just about that.
What year am I born? You don't remember, huh?
Well, I told
nice
you,
job,
dude,
man.
The Tylenol screws everything up. All right, dude.
Yeah, man. All right, I'll make sure to take a double dose. All right, bye.
Okay. He caught me.
Good evening. How can I help you?
Oh, hello. I was wondering if I could talk to a customer that's in there right now.
Who are you looking for, sir?
His name is Steve Belt. Kind of like
you can hold on.
Bald guy. Okay.
Hello.
Steve.
Yeah.
Could you pick me up something to eat? I'm hungry.
Is it, I'm sorry, who is it? Is it Joe or Chris?
Oh, my name's Brad.
Oh, Brad.
Brad Carter.
How do I know you?
You don't. I just saw that you were there on Foursquare, and I live kind of nearby.
Oh, okay.
And I was hoping you could come by my house. I'll give you my address.
Sure.
Something with bacon on it.
Something with bacon on it.
Yeah.
This guy, his name Brad, wants something with bacon on it, and I'm supposed to deliver it for him because he saw me on Foursquare just now.
And you have to pay for it, too.
Oh, and I get to pay for it and deliver it. What's the tip?
It's only a couple blocks out of the way, so.
Oh, it's only a couple. All right, Brad. Thanks for calling.
Well, wait. You didn't take my order yet. And you need to get the girl.
You can get order to the girls, but not me.
No. You're going to come by and get it. Bring it to me.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. I'm not asking. I'm telling you.
Okay. Yeah, nice try.
Hey, motherfucker. I'm going to call you at the next place you go.
Okay. Do that.
I will. You just wait.
Okay. All right. Thanks. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Foursquare Grill, how can I help you?
Hello. I was wondering if it'd be possible to have somebody page there, a customer that's there. Her name's Christine White.
Okay. What does she look like?
She's got blonde hair. She's, you know, about 30.
Hold on. There's one group of girls in here, that's it.
Yeah, she's with a group.
Okay, hold on. Hello?
Hello, Christine?
Yeah?
Hey, can you pick me up some onion rings?
Who is this?
It's Roy. Just pick
it's
me.
Who?
It's Roy Gerbil. Can you pick me up some onion rings and bring them home?
I don't... Exactly. Someone's got to be in the bar. But where? And I don't know anyone named Roy.
What are you talking about? You don't know me.
Roy?
What the hell, Christine?
I don't know anyone named Roy.
We've known each other since grade school. What the hell?
Oh, no. Someone that I checked in and someone saw me.
What? You're talking crazy, Christine.
This is kind of funny, though. Seriously, where are you?
I'm in Oregon.
No.
No, I really am in Oregon.
That doesn't even make sense. You could at least show your face. You're clever. You could at least show your face.
Show my face? I'm not there. I'm asking you to get me some onion rings.
Thought you know I was at the chicken coop.
I saw you on Foursquare.
Mm-hmm. Right, but if you're in Oregon, you don't know about this. But seriously, stop screwing with me. Who are you?
Why couldn't I be in Oregon? They have Foursquare in Oregon, you know.
I don't think I have any followers that are from Oregon.
I don't have to be a follower. I can just go to Foursquare and see that you're there.
Come on. Just, like, show your face and be a man about it.
I'm too scared. I'm afraid to talk to women.
All right, well, I'm going to hang up then.
Yeah, it's best that we hang up because I'm really afraid now. I'm sweating and stuff. It's gross.
All right. Bye.
Bye, Christine.
So, see, I bettered her, you know. Yeah, she hasn't made a Foursquare post since then.
I guess you're raising awareness then, huh?
Yeah. That's also the funny thing. Like, these people, when they get paged and something crazy is said to them, they always Twitter about it, of course.
Oh, man.
So you get to hear their reaction, kind of, after we've hung up.
You know, I'm going to have to try that now. I'm going to have to start fucking with people.
Everybody should do that. It's so easy. You just go to Stalk Me, please... Or what is it? PleaseRobMe.com and start calling the phone numbers that pop up on there. And it's like guaranteed prank call.
That is too great. And you know what? It's even better because it's just some random place that they're at. You know? It's not like calling their cell phone or something. It's just you're calling the business.
Yeah. I called one the other night that was a Walgreens and I told him I was him from the future and started telling him not to buy Tylenol and it was important to our future together or something. I told him I was him from the year 2016.
What did he say?
I think he's the one that got pissed and yelled fuck you at me. He's like, I don't know who the fuck you are, but you need to stop calling me. And there was another guy at a gym.
Technically, you weren't off, though. I mean, you're calling the business. So.
That's true. Yeah, he should yell at the business. Some guy was doing a workout at a gym. I had him, like, go into the gym and, you know, pull him off of whatever machine he was on and come to the phone, and I told him his credit card was bad, and he got really pissed off at me. And I started being silly at him, but before that, he completely believed me. He was going to go out to his car and get his credit card for me. So I probably could have got him to tell me his credit card number.
And, you know, people don't understand, you know, how easy it is to, you know, get information like that, you know?
Yep. I plan to raise awareness nonstop.
And having fun while you're doing it.
Hey, Roy?
Yeah?
Yeah, what's up, man? It's Craig.
Yeah, this is Roy from the Visa MasterCard validation. It appears the card you're using there with Golds is not validating with us.
Should. I've been using it like every day. It's a MasterCard from Citibank.
That's right.
Yeah, I mean,
The one ending with 5825?
I don't have it. Well, it's in my car right now.
I see. Yeah, we're just going to have to ask you to leave the gym until you can get this taken care of and paid.
Shouldn't be a problem. When did you guys run it?
Looks like we've tried to run it several times today.
Oh, you have? Uh-huh. I have my wallet in my car. I'll go grab it again for you guys.
Oh, okay.
Every other business I've been with today has been using that card with no problem.
Oh, I find that hard to believe.
I find it hard to believe, too. I just got back from Big Bear.
Mm-hmm.
I used it to pay for my lift tickets, my hotel, everything today.
Yeah, you probably didn't pay any of them because it's not a good card.
I know that'd be a good card.
That's not a good card because we've been trying to run it all day. I don't appreciate your attitude about it either.
My attitude? Dude, I've been using it. That's the one credit card I use for everything.
Well, you probably ran it up too high. Ran out of money.
You're telling me I ran out of money, dude?
That would be my guess because it's not going through.
I have about $400,000 in that account. I don't think I ran out of money, but I'll go grab the card. Yeah,
I find that hard to believe. I think you need to manage your finances better.
Yeah, I think you're just fucking with me.
What are you talking about?
Hey, Roy. Sounds like a joke to me, dude. Who are you?
I don't joke. I'm a Christian.
In Folsom, where you can pre-order New Moon. This is Zika. How can I help you?
Hello. I was wondering if I could have a customer page that's in there right now.
Who are you looking for?
Her name's Sabrina Shoemake.
Yeah, she's coming.
Oh, okay, thank you.
Hello?
Hey, Sabrina, this is Chris Tompkinson. I'm with the Blockbuster corporate office.
Yeah.
And we wanted to let you know that you're not welcome in our stores anymore. We don't want you shopping here.
This is a joke.
No, ma'am. I'm sorry, it's just because of your reputation and everything. So we prefer that you would stick to, you know, like maybe Redbox kiosks or something and stay out of our stores.
Okay,
so we really don't want you, and please leave. Is that understood?
Not really, no.
I don't know how I could make it any clearer. You're not welcome at Blockbuster anymore. So please.
Okay, I'm going to hang up now.
No, please don't rent any movies. I'm canceling your account right now. Oh, look, I just pushed the button. It's canceled.
Hello, could you tell... Hi, could you tell David to pick me up a burrito?
Yes,
I don't want to talk to him. Just put a burrito on his... just add a burrito, because I want him to bring me a burrito.
Okay,
just
sure.
A regular burrito. Just put it on the tab.
Just burritos?
Yeah, just one burrito for me. And David will pay for it.
Okay, sure.
Are you going to do that?
Yeah, sure, right now.
Okay.
I'm talking to take burrito.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye.
Have a good day. Goodbye.
You too.
Foursquare is an application designed for most smartphones and can be downloaded at foursquare.com. The other website we mentioned, pleaserobme.com, is a humorous site designed to raise awareness by encouraging burglars to rob people's houses since they know these Foursquare users aren't home. If you'd like to call people like we did in this episode, pleaserobme.com is a great place to find places to call. Another place you can get this information from is search.twitter.com. By entering the number 4sq.com into the search box, you'll see the same results that you can find on pleaserobme.com. If you'd like to see what these stalker victims said on their Twitter accounts after they were called, visit the PLA forums at phonelosers.com and look for the new message board called Let's Stalk People. Links to prank victims' Twitters, blogs, and Facebook accounts can be found there, along with even more prank calls to Foursquare locations. Foursquare-type applications are becoming more popular every day. Yelp.com and Loop.com have a similar service that lets you check into places you're visiting. A site called Blippi.com lets people transmit what they're purchasing on their credit cards in real time, which could allow someone to know where they're shopping at. You may notice other similar services showing up in your friends' Twitter and Facebook feeds. Thanks goes out to Grishnav, who made one of the calls you heard in this episode, and 9X, who made several calls posted on the PLA forums. If you decide to make calls like these, please remember to prank responsibly, and don't say anything that could involve emergency services. Be sure to visit phonelosers.org to read show notes with links and more details on Foursquare and other similar services. If you have any thoughts about the Foursquare phenomenon, leave a voicemail at 505-796-4020 or email me at radio@phonelosers.org. And don't forget to listen to Cacti Radio at cactiradio.com for nonstop PLA fun.
Hey, Lindsay.
Yeah.
Hey, you don't need to buy any pie. You're looking a little thick around the edges, you know?
Who is this?
Don't be buying pie. Come on, you know you don't need it. Why don't you go to the gym instead?
Where is he?
Go to the gym instead.
Who is this?
It's Roy. I'm just some internet stalker. I saw you on Foursquare, so I thought I would give you a call. Isn't that freaky?
Who is this?
I told you I'm Roy. I'm an internet stalker.
This is Mike.
No, I'm Roy. I'm an internet stalker. I'm stalking you on the internet.
Oh, okay.
You shouldn't transmit your location nonstop.
Okay.
Cut that out and stop eating all that pie.
Oh my God.
I'm serious. No more pie for you.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah.
No, hang up. It's a stalker.